another Grandeur Africa video to bring you some insights in farming. Hello everyone. When we say capsicums, we mean business. In this video, we'll be showing you how we are growing capsicums hydroponically in Kenya. We monitor the growth of capsicums from transplanting to the flowering stage and now to the maturity stage where we harvest, grade, and pack them ready for delivery. This is a hydroponic trough system. The troughs are fitted with drip lines that ensure that our crops get the nutrient-rich water. You have been asking us why we grow capsicums hydroponically instead of conventional farming. Here is Samuel Mbogwa, our hydroponic consultant, to answer that question.
We need to do it hydroponically because of very many advantages, such as saving on the land space that you need to grow the capsicums. You also save on water because there is a recycling system. The system is closed, so you can recycle water. And you also, as you're recycling water, you're also recycling nutrients. So it's also a plus. Another thing is that you cut down on labor. You do not need to do weeding because there are no weeds to pull in hydroponics. And finally, the pests and disease control is reduced by 80%. So it is something that is quite advantageous. And with hydroponics also, you do not need to do crop rotation. So you can grow the same crop over and over. If you're doing the colored capsicums, you can do them without seeding.
The reason we are growing colored capsicums is because of the value compared to other common vegetables that can be grown in this trough system. Take a look at this table. Lettuce, 30 Kenyan shillings per piece. Tomatoes, 50 Kenyan shillings per kilogram. Red onions, 80 Kenyan shillings per kilogram. Colored capsicums, 95 to 100 Kenyan shillings per kilogram. Capsicums will fetch a higher price in the market per kilogram compared to other vegetables. Mr. Mbogwa will tell us some more reasons apart from price that made us choose colored capsicums.
If you think about the amount of work you put when growing colored capsicums, for example, compared to tomatoes. For tomatoes, the vines, you know, are very long, and when they grow tall, above your chest level, you have to bring them down. But for colored capsicums, they grow like a bush, and you do not have to bring the vines or the crop down. So it saves a lot of energy and a lot of need for labor. Again, compared to tomatoes, the value is higher and you need less labor in terms of staking and trellising. It's not as much as the tomatoes, although you will need to support the crop as it branches.
Our customers have been telling us that our capsicums have a better quality and more shelf life compared to the conventional produce. This is true because by using hydroponics, our capsicums have access to all the nutrients they need when growing and use majority of their energy to make more and tastier fruits. You can increase your capsicum's shelf life by doing this simple step.
You can increase the shelf life by wrapping them using a cling film paper, as you can see. But even if you will not wrap and just put it on the shelf, what we have noticed with our produce is that they have 21 days shelf life. If you wrap like this and put it on the shelf, you know, you can have them fresh even for a month. When you wrap them like this and put in the fridge, you know, in the vegetable section of your fridge, they will last even longer. The reason we wrap is to ensure that the skin does not lose moisture. If the skin loses moisture, it becomes wrinkled. You know, it looks flaccid, it looks like it's not firm. But wrapping them like this, you know, increases their shelf life. So of a conventional produce, hydroponic produce has a very good shelf life. It's one of the reasons why we practice hydroponics on these veggies.
To meet the high demand for our produce, we Granger Africa offer a market segment for our farmers through contract farming. Majority of farmers in Kenya have been struggling with the pricing of their products because of brokers who take their products at very low prices or refuse to offtake farmers' produce, excuse being quality. This is how Granger Africa is mitigating this problem.
When you're growing your produce, it is in our interest to ensure that there is consistent production. So it is for that reason we offer agronomy support to your staff or to you as a farmer to ensure that the crops, there is no crop failure or that the crops do not experience a lot of pests or disease and then lower your production. So we would like to, walk this journey with you. Instead of waiting until you have ready produce and then say the produce does not meet our target market. But when we walk this journey together, then it means that we be the ones of taking the produce and cannot reject what we have shown you or how we've shown you to grow the product, So it's a win-win situation if you ask me. And I would like to urge anyone out there who has a farm that's lying idle, has some funds, and you do not want to resign from your current job or current venture, and you would like to increase your income base by farming and doing it like a true business, we would like to come and bridge that gap of know-how, of agronomy, of market, and make your work easier as a producer.
In addition to the agronomy that we offer to ensure the quality of the product, we also offer value addition training. This is to give our farmers more and better ways to earn extra revenue for some of the grade 3 tomatoes or capsicums that do not make it to the market. Remember, value added products have a higher shelf life and fetch a higher value in the market. Red capsicums can be used to make pasta sauce, barbecue sauce, meatball sauces, and other sauces. Yellow capsicums can be canned or processed into powder. For tomatoes, you can make canned sauce.
You do not need to throw away produce. Rather, I think we can urge everyone to, plug into our value addition trainings so that we are able to demonstrate to you how you can add value to your products, how you can add more money to your pockets, rather than just throwing away your produce.
We hope this was an informative video. For more videos on farming in Africa, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our Facebook page, and visit our website www.grangerafrica.com. See you in the next one.